He's intimidated. He's intimidated by Butler and Reiner. The man knows to keep quiet.
You just said that you were going to take The Rock straight to school. School. Well, The Rock could just imagine what you were like in high school. The oldest 27-year-old senior the world has ever seen. Standing out in front of your house with your mama and that short little yellow bus pulling up in front.
Meep, meep. Meep, meep. Meep, meep.
Walking on the bus, going to class, getting inside the classroom, teacher up on the blackboard. Okay, class, what is 2 plus 2? Do you know Booker? Okay, I know the answer to that. 2 plus 2? Thomas Jefferson, sucker. Obviously, Booker T, you're a highly intelligent man. But not as intelligent as your boss, Shane McMahon. He obviously had more intelligence than you because he didn't want to come out here tonight after what The Rock did to him on SmackDown. Rock bottom right through the table.
That's a fact.
But The Rock guesses that old saying is true. Booker T, hair done by Whoopi, Shane McMahon, still a pussy.
Wait a second, Rock. That was a good one, but you're forgetting one half of the family. I mean, look what's standing in the ring right now. You've got a man beast and a hose beast. I mean, we're dealing with the gore and the horror.
Shut up! Enough! These two clowns are gonna get their asses kicked by the Alliance. And I'm promising you that.
Oh, The Rock understands this one, Chris. This is a little rhyming contest between you and The Rock. Well, The Rock has got one better than that. Oh yeah, The Rock has got one better than that. Here's a little rhyme. Here's Booker T and Shane, the punk ass sucker, and the silver spoon motherfucker.
No, that's enough. That's enough. Rock, Jericho, if you want Booker T and Rhino so bad, Booker, wait. If they want you two so bad, why wait till SummerSlam?
Yeah, why wait?
My thoughts exactly.
You know, I think that's just what Y2J and The Rock wanted. Thank you, Stephanie. You're the best. I mean best.
It's gonna be The Rock, Y2J, against Booker T and Rhino tonight in front of millions of people, live, Raw is War. You see, The Rock and Chris Jericho, we're gonna take you two on a little geography lesson. Yeah, we're gonna go to France, we're gonna go to China, we're gonna go to Russia, but don't worry, we get in trouble, we could use Stephanie McMahon's breast as a flotation device, but yeah, It doesn't matter where we go. Around the world once, some places twice. The fact remains, we will wind up right back here whooping your candy asses all over Chicago.
Yeah, I'm all right.
Other than Benoit putting a crippled crossface on me again, that damn Eddie Guerrero doing the Macarena all over my ribs. Other than that, I'm cool, man. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, well, they jumped me too. Benoit and Guerrero, they're out of control right now.
Out of control? Out of control? They're gonna get their monkey asses whooped tonight. The Rocket.
Wait. What about SummerSlam? I mean, what about your ribs?
The Rock's ribs? The Rock's ass? The Rock's got hurt ribs. Big deal. It's no big deal at all. There is no quit. In The Rock, no quitting me, my friend. No way. The Rock says this. You go ahead and take out The Rock's ribs. Fine. Take off one of The Rock's arms. He'll fight you with the other arm. You take off one of The Rock's legs. The Rock will hobble and hobble and hobble and keep hobbling and whoop the monkey ass with the other leg. Easy, big fella. Easy. Oh, yeah. You go ahead and you can take off one of The Rock's testicles, the people's testicles. Oh, yeah. The Rock will take the other one. Throw it way up in the air. Keep watching it. Damn, that's a good-ass testicle. The Rock will take his boot, shine it up real nice. Excuse The Rock. Turn that sumbitch sideways
and stick it straight up Benoit Guerrero's candy asses.
Hey, come on, man. Let's go.